As we finally came lurching out of Vietnam, we were beginning to doubt ourselves. And that's a foreign feeling for an American. We seldom doubt ourselves. This turned out to be the most bitter, the most divisive, or second most bitter and second most divisive war in our entire history. And we still hurt because of it. We have feelings of guilt about Vietnam.
More than four decades after the war ended, the divisions it created between Americans have not yet wholly healed. Lessons were learned and then forgotten. Divides were bridged and then widened. Old secrets were revealed and new secrets were locked away. The Vietnam War was a tragedy, immeasurable and irredeemable. But meaning can be found in the individual stories of those who lived through it. Stories of courage and comradeship and perseverance, of understanding and forgiveness, and ultimately, reconciliation.
They shared the weight of memory. They took up what others could no longer bear. Often they carried each other, the wounded or weak. They carried infections. They carried chess sets, basketballs, Vietnamese English dictionaries, insignia of rank, bronze stars and purple hearts, plastic cards imprinted with the code of conduct. They carried diseases, among them malaria and dysentery. They carried lice and ringworm and leeches, paddy algae and various rots and molds. They carried the land itself, Vietnam, the place, the soil, a powdery orange-red dust that covered their boots and fatigues and faces. They carried the sky, the whole atmosphere. They carried it, the humidity, the monsoons, the stink of fungus and decay, all of it. They carried gravity. They moved like mules. By daylight, they took sniper fire. At night, they were mortared. They crawled into tunnels and walked point and advanced under fire. But it was not battle. It was just the endless march. Village to village. They marched for the sake of the march. They plodded along slowly, dumbly, leaning forward against the heat, unthinking, all blood and bone. Simple grunts soldiering with their legs, toiling up the hills and down into the paddies and across the rivers and up again and down, just humping. One step and then the next and then another. They made their legs move. They endured.